remember we did Wombat Stew, and so that was working on telling a story through movement and also experimenting with different voices and accents. So fast forward to this semester, we have been taking on those skills and we have been doing lots of games and activities based on different places around the world and different environments. So we've travelled to snow, the beach in Simpson here, jungle, and we've done lots of games and activities based around those places and how characters are influenced and react to those different places. So I've brought in term three lots of different hats, okay? So got a range of what we had: a grandma, we had a pirate, we had, who else did we have? We have a musician, we've got triathlete, you know, we've got everyone. Cover it all. And so I really wanted to work with you two, going right down to basics. So what's their character's age, their name, and also around the term backstory. So what's been happening in the past with this character that leads them all the way to the present. Okay? So in particular, we did a game on a tropical island, and I set them up with an improvisation game. So the improvisation is all about thinking on the spot, using their imagination, working together as a team. It's a very big bond of team working towards this term. And what they had to do in their group is they had to come up with a story on how they could survive on a tropical island. Okay, so that's been the structure for our play, our scaffolding. And I've taken all of their ideas from that little activity and I've branched out into our play, The Tropical Island of Mystery. So it's actually very nice and short and sharp since we've only had 6 lessons this term. And we've done, what else did we do? We did script writing with them. We did voice recordings, as you'll hear. So you're going to see everything today. It's all created by the students. They have lots of fun doing it. And as a bonus, you'll be seeing some improvisation from me today, as Phoebe's actually away, but I hope I can do her character justice. So she did grandma, and she did such a good job. One of the oldest characters there, like, she's such a little, you all know Phoebe, she's such a little girl, she just has this big personality, and yeah, hope we can do it justice for her, and I hope you all enjoy. Okay, so, well, oh yeah, and also, if you didn't see, up on the wall there, I put up all of their planning that they did. So, we did some games based on stage direction, so learning downstage, upstage, stage left. So trying to get into that mindset of theatre-like language, instead of just going, I'm going to go over here, or I'm going to stand over here. It's like, no, we're like moving downstage. So when I move up into the older level, that's sort of the term that teachers will be talking to them as. So yeah, so doing that, so yeah, if you, at the end, you can have a little look. You can actually take those pieces of paper home that they worked on. So what they did is they plotted on the paper where they'll be standing on stage. So they'll put it number one, and so just say, grandma moves down stage. And in the second scene, grandma moves stage left. And so we took actually about 3 lessons in rotation to work on learning about stage direction. And they also, we do also did the script writing there, so we've got a couple of lines. So all of these lines that you're hearing today, all the characters, all their imagination, all of their ideas. So you can have a look at that. And then after, we're going to see if we can fit in a couple of our favourite games and activities. So a couple of them involve the parents, so more than welcome to join. And at the end, I'll just do a little presentation for each student and